foodies, Chill Broth Vegan here. Now, I don't know about you guys, but lately I have been craving pho. Not pho, but pho. Pho usually contains some type of meat, bone broth, and or fish sauce. But today I'm gonna show you how to not only make it vegan, but delicious. It will be unforgettable. So if you wanna learn how to make this delicious, light, and refreshing pho, keep watching and let's get cooking.
So you're going to need 2 pieces of ginger and 2 onions. You're gonna cut those in half and lay them cut side down on your baking tray and then broil them in the oven for about 15 minutes or until they get nice and crispy. While that's going, you're gonna gather your other ingredients. I have some vegetable broth. And here I have a pho spice seasoning bag. It's got all the spices you need. It has the word pho on it, so I'm assuming this is the right thing. And here you can see all the ingredients inside as well as this little white baggie, which you're going to be using to cook your spices in. So it's actually a pretty large bag, as you can see, and you can even reuse this, just wash it after you're done using it. If you're enjoying this video, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and share. See you. And here I have some lump candy, which may also be labeled as rock candy, and we have our rice noodles. Now, they come in different sizes. You can get them thick, you can get them thin. I have a kind of medium size here and it has the word pho on it. So these are also the right kind of noodles as well. Alrighty, so the ginger and onion should be done at this point. Now you do want it to be kind of crispy. Mine are not, and that's okay. We are rolling with it. The onion looks pretty good. You want it to be charred because it's gonna give it a really nice deep flavor. Okay, so I'm just flipping it over to check it. They're not really charred, but I'm not too worried about it. It's still gonna be good. It's still gonna be bomb. Here we have the spices from our seasoning packet. I have 4 of the star anise, 1 piece of cinnamon bark. We got a big piece or 2 small pieces, and I've got 8 cloves. I've got 2 cardamom pods, and then I have the other seasonings, about a tablespoon. Look in the description. I have all of the measurements and ingredients below. Okay, now we need to toast our spices. I have this pan on the burner. It is set to high. You're just gonna pour all of your spices in there and very quickly stir them up for about 2 minutes, being careful not to burn anything. After the 2 minutes, you're going to remove all the spices except for the cinnamon bark. You wanna keep that back in there. And then you're going to get your onion and ginger into the pot. Even though we did remove the spices, we still need to cook them in the broth. So you're going to be putting them in that baggie that came with the seasoning pack. You're just gonna tie it, and I tied it to the side of the pot just so that I could remove it easier when I needed to. Once that is done, you're gonna pour in your vegetable broth and your water. Don't forget to put in your rock candy and some salt to taste. You're going to bring that to a boil, let it boil for about 10 minutes. After 10 minutes, you want to find and remove that cinnamon stick, and then you're going to simmer it covered for about 20 minutes. In the last 5 minutes, you're going to add in some chopped carrots and let that boil for a while. And then in the last 2 minutes, you're going to add in your bok choy. Just be careful not to overcook the bok choy or it's going to be really soggy and just not good. All right, then when everything's done, you're going to fish out the bok choy, and then you're going to take out the ginger and the onion as well. Feel free to use whatever kind of protein you want for this dish. I'm using this soy sauce stew tofu, which comes chopped up a little bit, and it looks like this. And I'm just going to stir fry that in the pot with just a little bit of soy sauce and a little bit of sesame oil, and then it's ready to serve. For the rice noodles, you're just going to cook it according to the directions on the package. Some need to be soaked beforehand, some don't. I just had to boil mine in water for about 6 to 8 minutes. And here is the fun part. We are ready to plate it all up. This is your chance to be creative, make it look pretty, make it look delicious, make food art. And these are enoki mushrooms, in case you were wondering. I do put them in there uncooked because once I put the broth in, it's just gonna cook it all down and make it nice and tender. As a final touch, I'm adding some cilantro and a little bit of red pepper flakes just to give it a nice little kick. And we're done. And if you still feel like you need more flavor, you can add hoisin sauce, soy sauce, sriracha, whatever you need to get that taste.
Here's the pho up close and personal. I really can't tilt it any further, so I hope you guys can see, because I don't want to spill the broth.
It smells divine, so I'm gonna go ahead and dig in.
It looks so good, I don't want to mess it up, but here we go. Here's the noodles.
The broth is really light and refreshing. It would be even better if it had a little bit of lime squeezed over top, but I don't have any. The red pepper flakes give it a tiny little bit of a kick. Now, I know a lot of people don't like cilantro, but I do, and it just goes so well with it.
When you're eating pho, a lot of the time they will come with bean sprouts. I don't like bean sprouts, so I did not add them. That's the great thing about cooking, you can customize it based on your own preference. So if you like bean sprouts, more power to you, just pile them on. More for you, really.
As I suspected, the seasoned tofu goes really well with this dish. It has a lot of the same spices as the broth, so they really go well together.
I've said it before and I will say it again, you can veganize pretty much anything and pho is no exception. This is just the perfect dinner if you don't want anything too heavy. Like I said, it's very light, it's very refreshing, and a little bit of lime goes a long way. If you've gone vegan and you're craving pho, I really do encourage you to try this recipe out. It is delicious. You can find most, if not all, of these ingredients at your local Asian store. Also, be very careful with your noodles. I would say just cook them as you go. I have used these rice noodles before, and once you drain them, if you let them sit, they do tend to get dry, and when you want to transfer them over into a container for storage, they tend to break. So I just cook what I need for that day for that meal. And the broth definitely tastes good the next day. When it sits overnight, I guess the seasonings all have time to kind of meld together and be even more delicious. I did make this yesterday and I tasted it, but today it tastes even better. Well, I'm really hungry now, so I'm gonna go ahead and finish this. But before you go, don't forget to like this video and subscribe for more. I'll see you guys in the next one. Hope you're staying happy, healthy, and safe. Bye.